In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit, fill the heart of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your divine love. Send forth your Spirit and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit did instruct the hearts of the faithful, grant us by the same Holy Spirit to release what is right and just, and always to rejoice in his consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, go into the whole world and proclaim the gospel to every creature. Whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. Whoever does not believe will be condemned. These signs will accompany those who believe. In my name, they will drive out demons. They will speak new languages. They will pick up serpents with their hands, and if they drink any deadly thing, it will not harm them. They will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. So then the Lord Jesus, after he spoke to them, was taken up into heaven and took his seat at the right hand of God. But they went forth and preached everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the word through accompanying signs. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you,
Praise
O Lord
to you,
Jesus
O Lord
Christ.
Jesus Christ.
Can you hear me?
Yes, Tita.
Yes, Tita, we can hear you.
Please go ahead with the three pointers.
The three pointers for today's gospel. Number one, in life, so long as we are willing to follow Jesus, he will definitely keep us true to God's name. Number two, when we do God's work, we will often be despised and even face humiliation and scorn. Number three, however, Jesus is faithful to all those who brave such experiences, and he will always look after us. This is evident when he said, not one of them is lost. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you very much, Tita Lynn. So today's gospel, no, is gospel according to Mark, and this is Ascension. Today is Ascension Sunday, so, and also at the same time, Happy Mother's Day to all of us.
Happy
Mother's Day.
Mother's Day.
To all of us.
Yeah. So anyway, I'm going to share to you, no, this this reflection from Haro Cathedral, no, beautiful reflection, no. It says here, this is about ascension. Move higher. Move higher though. Grow up. Ascension happens when you leave behind what holds you back. Drowned by what the world has offered for our pleasure, we may have somehow become aware of how far we've gone through from getting closer with our relationship with God. For some time, the desires of the flesh had taken over that which should belong to the needs of our souls. We become too preoccupied with the worries not necessary with our salvation, but that which please the cravings of our temporal wants. Our leakage to sin had made our souls to creep, but a shift to our renewal with a change of heart has brought it to an ascent. We live deep down behind our old selves and rise up higher to clinch the waiting arms of God. In our purification, we just don't uplift our souls, but the welfare of our body's sanity. It's only then that our conversion becomes our ascension. Very good. Very nice, no? It's only then that our conversion becomes our ascension. Let your spark help others discover their glows. To you, O Lord, I lift up my soul. Amen.
Amen.
So a beautiful interpretation of today's gospel, no? About our own personal ascension. We have this ascension if we leave behind something. So especially our old self, no? Our sinning, our old self being sinful, yun, we will leave behind all those and ascend to a higher level. That's our personal ascension. Amen.
Amen.
Anything who wants to reflect before we do our sharing, we will talk about our mother. Very, very precious person in our life.
I read this Marino. It's good also. Marino, that's Marino.
Please go ahead.
A policeman was about to be assigned to a faraway place. So he said to his wife, "Take care of the children. Teach them about our faith so that they will grow up to become responsible and God-loving individuals." The wife followed the command of her husband. She taught the children the teachings of the faith, introduced Jesus to them, and educated them about discipline, good manners, and values. After 5 years, he came back. His children were all grown up, and he was so happy because they were all wonderfully brought up by his wife. Before Jesus ascended to heaven, he gave his disciples this marching order: proclaim the gospel to every creature. Same with us. It's a marching order for us also. All the disciples lived out this command of Jesus to the fullest. In fact, the majority of them were martyred for the sake of advancing the gospel. The words of Jesus are like a stream of water. They endlessly flow with the passing of time. And these words speak to us now so that we can respond. The Lord tells us that we too have a mission. And what is that mission? We are also tasked by Jesus to proclaim and live the good news. Have we shared and lived the gospel? The majority of us may not have shared and lived it yet. Therefore, we have to live and share it now. Not tomorrow, not next week, but now. Why now and not on a later date? Because many are in need of the life-transforming words of Jesus. Many are being eaten alive by worldliness, hedonism, and sinfulness. Therefore, we must share the good news as the disciples did, because the Lord commands us to do so. Let us share Jesus' teaching through how we live, because we become more fruitful and useful followers of Jesus when we live our faith, obey him, and help advance his teachings. We allow ourselves to become blessings for others when we share and give Jesus to them. We also allow Jesus to bless us more, not with material wealth, but with spiritual gifts when we follow his marching order. Question is, have you already followed this marching order of the Lord? Amen. Marino, amen. Das Marino.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much.
Marching order. Well, malinaw naman sinabi dito. It's very clear. We are all given the talents. Now is the time to use them. We do not bury in the ground these talents, or we will be held responsible. We have to use them. All that is needed is faith. And we were given that faith when we were baptized. What we have to do now is to strengthen that faith through prayers, actions, sacraments. It's all in the church also. given us that the tools spreading the good news. Yeah, we don't have an excuse. You'll have to account for that, for those or all those things if we fail to do so. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Tito Manny. So it's about commissioning, no? It's about us having this responsibility to spread the good news, no? To spread His love, to spread the eternal life, to spread the goodness of the Lord, to glorify His name. Yun. Have we done it yet? Have we started? Or we don't have enough time, or we don't know whether we've done enough or not. But personally, no, this ministry, the Prayer Warriors, no, ministry is one way of spreading the good news. So, you know,
talent.
Let's
we were given the talent.
Yeah.
We do not hide them.
Share your talent. Amen. Tita Kors, do you have something to say, Tita Kors?
I thought we're going to talk about the mothers.
Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, we'll talk about the mothers and then we will say something short. We will say something about our mothers.
I'll share something about holy moments. Every day, our life is one long moment, seamless. Okay, it's one long moment that are marked by events, and each event is a micro moment. Okay, so we're talking about ascension and about being sent forth to spread the news. So we can use the moments in our life daily, because we cannot aspire to do really great things every day. But every day we are faced with micro moments. How do we make them holy? So that by doing so, we always tap into the power that Jesus gave to us through the Holy Spirit when He went up to heaven. Okay? And He sent the Holy Spirit to us. Each moment requires, or each moment is like a decision point. But the moment, what is a moment? For example, what's a moment? This is a moment. What we have now is a moment in our life. We are sharing. So we, each one of us, is at a decision point. How do I make use of this point, of this moment? I can use it in order to be a better person, or I can make a decision that is more worldly, or I can make a decision that's more spiritual. And when we decide to do that, making decisions that are more attuned to the spiritual aspect of our being, we are making the moment a holy one. And a holy moment every day, if we try to make as many holy moments as we can, then we are spreading, actually, Jesus says kindness. Jesus says love for others, because every moment of our life also is connected or affects some other person's moment. So every time that there's a moment in our life, we can choose. For example, okay, basic, demarites, chismis. When we are faced with that moment, at that very, very moment, we can ask ourselves, do I make this a worldly moment, or can I make this a holy moment that is good for my soul? So then, if you want to make it a holy moment, you avoid adding more to the chismis, okay? Maybe you don't want to hurt the feelings of your friends, but what you can do is from your end, you don't add more. Like, may sunog na nga, wag mo nang gatungan. Okay? So, those are the holy moments. And, you know, if once we know what the moments are in our life, this author said that when we make decisions and we choose to have the moment, to make the moment a holy one, it makes it easy for us to look back and smile. Diba? Kung minsan may ginagawa tayo, we say something or we do something or we make decisions that make us shudder several years hence. Bakit po ginawa yun? Okay. That means that moment was not holy. So we said we should make decisions so that 2 years, 2 months, 2 weeks from now, when you look back, you will say, uulitin ko ulit yun. Because it is good. It gives me a good feeling even now. So, holy moments will give us those memories. Amen.
Amen. Yeah, thank you very much, Cor. Yeah, beautiful. Oh, we are just interconnected with each other, no? And then everything we do, everything we think, every micro moment. I like that micro moment in our life, which can lift up somebody, or something else, you know.
No, it can actually, it can set the tone. It can set the tone of how our day is going to proceed. The moment we wake up, that's a micro moment. You can make a decision then. Do you get up and do something right away? Or do you sit up and pray first? That's a micro moment that you have just made holy.
Holy. Mm-hmm. Holy.
June.
Please go ahead, Tita Nixon.
Yung sinasabi lang ni Tita Kors, parang I just remember a poem, 3 lines lang naman. For today, well lived makes every yesterday a dream of happiness and every tomorrow a vision of hope.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Yeah. How beautiful. Thank you, Nix. Yeah.
Yes. And yung sinasabi ni Tita Kors.
Beautiful. Thank you, Tita Nix. So, any other comments or piece of your thought? Beautiful gospel and Mother's Day. We remember our mother as we are today because of our mother. What we are today because of our dearest mother. Yeah.
And tomorrow. Yeah.
Huh?
Nice, very beautiful mix.
Oh.
Who wrote that? Ralph Waldo Emerson?
I'll forward it to you.
Very nice.
Salutation of the Dawn, ang title ng poem.
So,
and I think of beauty is a joy forever. Mama Mary is a beautiful, and it was
really beautiful.
She is a
most beautiful. Huh? Sa mga apparitions, no, of Mama Mary, no, the first thing that they describe is very beautiful, very beautiful, young and young. So, wow. That's our most beautiful mother, but we are also have our own mother here, no? At least Tita Helen has still her mom.
Yes,
92 years old.
Yes,
and who else dito na may mommy pa, may mama? I think si Tita Helen lang. You are so blessed, no, na ang mother po is naserbihan mo.
Yes.
So let's say something about our mom, no, short lang. Tita Helen.
For me, I am really very grateful and thankful to the Lord that up to this moment, I'm already 70, I still have our mother. And last night, we celebrated Mother's Day in advance lang kasi today, it's a busy day for all my sisters. And happy man si Nanay last night. I came late because I went to another parish. And we still have our t-shirt given by our one of our brothers in Maryland. And we kept it and we wore it last night, except me, because I have my another t-shirt, Catholic Women's League. So I can say that my nanay is a very simple woman from Bugasong, Antique.
Antique si nanay.
So they met in Mindanao as teachers. And through her great sacrifices, we have nine of us, finished our education. And always I'm asking Nanay, what can you say about us? And I'm happy that you are all okay. And until now, I haven't heard Nanay speaking ill words towards us. Kasi very, very soft-spoken and very sacrificing. Now, I think I can say that Nana is reaping the fruits of her hardships, her toils. Yes. And it's always singing. She put many songs.
That means she's happy.
Yes, po. That's all.
Thank you, Tita Helen.
Her name, Tita, is Lutgarda. Very, very not common. Lutgarda.
Ah, Lutgarda.
This is the second.
Please go ahead, Tita Kors.
No, that's the second Lutgarda that I know.
Ah, because okay.
I have a friend whose name is also
Lutgarda. Not very common, no.
Yes.
So sino pa dyan ang who wants to say something about your mom?
Me. My mother is so strict. Because of her, I know how to do the household chores. Everyone has to have its own duty. And because of her, I know to iron, to cook, and to clean the house. She was so strict when coming from Rojas. Sabi niya, ano ito? Bakit hindi kayo naglinis? Hindi kayo na ganito. Although we clean. She was so strict sa mga bagay sa bahay. Uh-oh. Lahat kami may duty kami, washing the clothes, the plate, cleaning, kami nga mag-siblings, tapos mag-cooking. And Saturday or Sunday, my duty is to iron. The whole day, I iron the clothes. Yun naman, mahirap ang uniform natin noon because it's white. And so stiff because of the army roll. It's really hard.
No high school, puti so lahat,
I tried
all
hard
white.
To iron. So I was so thankful for her. Kaya natuto ako maglinis ng bahay, mag-cooking, maglaba,
it's
everything
true.
I know.
Tita Grace is very, very domesticated.
Except na lang nagkasakit ako sa heart. Medyo exempted ako sa mga medyo heavy nga work sa bahay. Pero still, we have to do our works. In light lang. Ayun.
Thank you, Tita Grace. I remember your mom, of course.
Lagi naman kami sa bahay.
So, Tita Cor, you want to say something? Sabay kayo ni Tita Grace na gano'n. Please go ahead.
We learned so much, so many things from our mother. But the one thing that I really treasure is the religious upbringing. Nanay taught us to believe in God. Not just to believe in God, but to believe in God's mercy. And then she said that maskin anong bigat na problema niya. That's what she said. Kasi siyam kami. Okay? Siyam kami. And school teacher si nanay, si tatay, walang fix na trabaho. So, at katulad din ni na ano, Tita Helen, lahat kami nakatapos kami. Okay.
Oh, yes. I can testify for that. Lahat kayo.
Ano, ang natutunan ko talaga kay nanay, sabi niya, pagka daw mabigat na ang problema niya, pumupunta siya kung saan may imahen ng Blessed Mother. And she cries there. Umiiyak talaga siya kay Mama Mary. And she said, somehow, help comes.
Oh, wow. The faith ng mother.
Yes. And because nakita naman namin talaga kung ano. Pinalaki niya kami na bawat isa may nobina sa Mahal na Birhen. So kaming mga tatlong babaeng bunso, Nuestra Senora de Salvacion. Yung sakitin sa amin kay San Vicente Ferrer. Yung wala ganun. So, kami meron kaming patron saint. Parang, ano yun, napaka-comforting na ano. Kung ako man ngayon ay nagdadasal, gawa talaga ni nanay. Na, ibig sabihin, naniniwala talaga ako na kung magdasal ka talaga, pakikinggan ka. Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Okay, any volunteer? We all have, I know we all have good mothers, no? Different intensity, different shape, different form. Nasabi kong different shape kasi ang mother ko and mother ni Tita Grace is medyo taba ba? I remember.
Yes.
Oh, pero not mentioning what kind of mother was, no, kasi very very just like what you said, no, na lahat na good descriptions na sa kanya, but I remember mostly, no, na we were taught, no, how to be just like Tita Cor, no, na to be religious, kaya nga kaming lahat is sa San Agustin kami para sa sa Catholic Catholic and conservative upbringing. Kasi ang San Agustin is very conservative, di ba? So anyway, I'm going to reverse this. I am just so thankful to our Lord, no, na we have expressed our love kay Mama, no, na before she died. Especially before she died, no, we had the chance, no, to embrace her because dying na siya, very very conscious pa, dying na siya, tapos manong shortness of breath niya, no, we were just so blessed, no, na to embrace our mom, tag isa-isa kami lahat, no, to embrace our mom and say thank you for all the goodness and all the things that she taught us. And we thank her for taking care of us. Taking care of us and for loving us and molding us to be good Christians. So she She died, no, holding hands with my dad. Yun lang ang kwan. She died holding hands with my dad. So this opportunity of expressing how we feel about her by and thanking her, no, for me that was the most beautiful moment in my life, no, one of the most beautiful moment in my life, no, na giving her thanks, no, and appreciating what she did for us as a good mother, very very good mother, just like all mothers, no, mga mother natin dito, no, I know, religious, hardworking, very very conservative and strict, mga ganyan ba kasi ang mother ko is a country mouse. Ang mother ko, ang tawag sa kanya is country mouse. Tapos ano ba, war bride. Kasi when my dad was a soldado during the World War, doon niya nakita ang mother ko. My mother was from Numancia, Aklan. And then she was brought to Iloilo City. Tapos what a big adjustment sa kanya ba at the age of 21. And then she had seven children kami plus one na adopted. So yun ang mother. Kaya nagiging religious tayo, soft-spoken, and they said like I'm 90%, the features of my mom 90% na sa akin. Kaya if you look at me, you look
yes.
at you. It's just like you're looking at my mom. Yeah, so that's my
I remember your mother June always carrying a Bible and the ano yung sa rosarito tapos sa uniform ano ba si
CWL
yes.
si
ano?
CWL naka blue
CWL
and so prayer book yeah
prayer book yan palagi rosary and the CWL
galing.
Uh-oh. Amen.
Amen. Yung mother ko naman, very conservative, strict to it. May strict. Bawal lumabas. Bawal makipaglaro. Pero matapang. Napakatapang ng mother ko, kinikwento mo. Kasi panahon ng occupation ng Japanese occupation. Nagbabarter sila. Kasi ang means of living noon, barter lang, by way of barter, palitan ng goods. Ngayon may incident na nahaharang sila. Yung mga hapon. Bahay. Pag hindi titingnan yung mga dala mo. Pag nahulihan ka ng hindi maganda, ba lucky go. Pero ang advantage ng mother ko, marunong siya maghapon. Kasi nag-nurse yung mother ko, nurse, sa hospital ng hapon, siya nag-work. So malam niya maghapon. So nakaka-lisot siya. Yun lang kwento niya. She died 89 years old. Yeah. May sakit siya. Ako rin nag-aalaga.
Oh, very lucky. Very blessed.
Pero ang tanong ngayon, tanong sa atin. No, hindi lang sa atin. Kung buhay ang nanay natin, ano kayo masasabi niya sa atin? Ano nangyari sa buhay natin? Maybe we can reflect that. Each one of us can reflect on what we did. Ano ang resulta? Bakit nagkaganon? Bakit ganito? Bakit ganon? Yan. Yan ang tanong. Siguro, each one of us can answer that based on our experiences. Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Amen.
Marunong pala magnipunggo ang mother mo. Sino pa? Any volunteer? Any volunteer before we...
May ngayon sa akin dito kayo.
Ha.
Ako, my mother, ano, panganay ako eh. At age 23, nanganak na ako ng nanay ko. Pero at age 39, namatay naman siya. Kaya 15 years lang kami kasama. Ang naalala ko lang sa mother ko, wala anak, every year, one year and 2 months, ano, mayroon pang dalawang magkapatid ko, tag 11 months lang ang gap. Sabi ko, wow. Para lang mamadali. Yan pala. Siguro, yan hanggang doon lang ang buhay niya.
Wow.
At saka, breastfeeding kami lahat. Breastfeeding kami lahat.
Ah, okay. 39 lang, no?
Oh, 39 lang. Kaya 15 years ko lang siya nakasama.
Oh.
Yan lang. Ano. Pero ano, napaka... Yung gusto niya malinis parati, yun ang gusto niya.
Oh,
at saka akong eldest, para pang, kaya nagagalit ako pag naalam kong buntis siya, kasi hindi ako makalaro.
Nag-help ka magyaya.
Kapatid o mag-saing. Kaya, yan ang member ko sa nanay ko. Pero na ano din ako, kasi bigla siyang namatay. Hindi pa na heart attack na siya. 4 months pa lang siya napapanganap. Yan ang ano, kaya hindi masyadong mahaba ang aming pagsama. Pero very loving siya, very caring.
Amen. Oo, thank you. Sino pa dyan?
Puro ako
may
na lang.
May isa akong idadagdag kung pwede.
Oo, sige.
May isa akong idadagdag because I think this is common for all mothers. Si nanay, just before she died, siguro mga 2 days before siya namatay, ako palagi yung kinakausap. Ang sabi sa akin, anong klaseng nanay ako? Naging mabait ako sa inyo. I mean, she was asking questions like this. Naging mabait ba akong nanay ninyo? Tapos, di sabihin ko, yes, mabait na mabait ka nanay. Then she said, pinalo ko ba kayo? I said, nay, hindi po. Pero nangungurot kayo. Oh, sabi ng ginang. Kasi siguro.
Disiplina. Siguro, hindi na yan pwede ngayon.
Siguro, sabi niya, mainit lang ang ulo ko. Nagalit kayo. Sa tingin mo, nagalit yung mga kapatid mo. Dahil kinukurot kayo. I mean, this really, I think our parents are like that. When they know that they are close to dying, they want to make sure that they will be remembered with love.
Yeah, it's true.
Kung gusto ni nanay na i-reassure siya na wala bang hurt feelings siya na anyone, na wala siya.
Talagang mabait si nanay mo.
So, palagay ko kung lahat ng nanay natin, kahit tayo siguro ng mga nanay, gugustuhin natin yung tanong sa mga anak natin na, was I enough of a mother to you? Yung parang ganun, no? Ganun yung feeling.
Very true. Very true.
Go ahead, Tita Nix. Please go ahead. Thank you, course.
I heard si Mama naman, parang like what Tita Grace mentioned, and a part of it also like what Tito Manny also mentioned. She was a very hard taskmaster, career woman kasi siya, and even as she was pursuing her career, pag sa bahay naman, like what Tita Grace said, talagang dapat marunong ka lahat. So, you, like Tita Grace, alam ko how to cook, alam ko how to iron clothes, alam ko how to sew buttons and everything like that. Kasi she wanted everything in place dahil she was very into paano yun, managing time, yung pag-uwi niya sa bahay dapat dapat malinis na o dapat ready na yung ano, so yung sinasabi na place for everything and everything in its place, palagi ko yung maalala kasi pag may hinahanap punta bakit wala dito, yung ganun. So a hard taskmaster, but she was she also insisted on our independence, like yung kailangan you know where your resources are. So good grades are expected. Parang hindi ka na dapat turuan. Dapat your grades should be good. Parang ganun. Pero I understood my mother in a way kasi maternal mortality, ano siya, June, yung she, her mother died giving birth to her. Namatay ang mama niya giving birth to her. And in the process, parang they just rolled her up in a, ano yun, yung bang mat, in a mat, kasi they were...
Banig.
Sa banig. Kasi they were trying to attend to the mother kasi nag-bleeding siya. So, somebody almost stepped on her. Parang that's her early... early life niya. So, parang naano ko rin si mama, naintindihan ko how she was hard on herself and she was hard on us. Pero she was breastfed by another woman, yung talagang naging parang, I thought she was really my grandmother, and in fact she wasn't my grandmother at all. Parang ano lang talaga, part of the neighbors, tapos yung talagang nag-care for her. So she grew up very independent kasi nag-asawa uli yung papa niya, si Lolo. So then she was already the youngest of five children. All of them are very professionals, because also Lolo was a pure Spaniard. Kaya I grew up think iba yung salita niya. So parang very, very strict din siya sa mga anak niya. So they all grew up very independent. And then mama also managed us like that. Pero just like what Tito Manny said, during the war, Tito Manny, my mom and my auntie, sisters, magkapatid sila, parang ganun ang ginagawa nila sa mama mo, yung nagbabarter. Tapos they were actually more than just bartering. They were bringing, paano yun, yung mga notes from the American soldiers, tapos papasok sila sa ano. So yun, parang may ano din, may danger din na they will be caught, pero hindi naman nangyari. So that's her experience with the war. Hindi naman masyadong pangit, pero may element of, parang yun, nagbabarter sila, yun pala, meron silang notes na they were ano. So, I grew up, both my parents kasi are career persons. So, there were times when they were not in the house most of the time. So, there were times when I was the mother and the father of my siblings. Parang kay Tita Megabilen, but it wasn't because of death Megabilen, they were just really pursuing their careers. So, parang ganun yon. Pero, maybe one thing that really, at least for my mom, she believed very much in Mama Mary. So, that's why also, I really have that. Like, I remember when we were growing up, yun, by 6 o'clock, you have to be home because you have to pray.
Oración. Angelus, oración or angelus.
Yeah. And then on weekends, we would all be praying the rosary together. Wala si papa, si mama lang. Kasi si papa would be out with his career also. Parang yun. But mama carried the family in terms of the religious upbringing. Yun, that's what I remember.
Amen.
Amen.
Very nice. So, Tita Bex, meron ka? Ikaw na lang.
I remember my mother, part of what Tita Belen had, part of Tito Manny had, part of Tita Grace. You know, she was strict. And she was very independent, really, because she was the youngest, but
He was almost always yung sinusundan siya sa mga kapatid na puro lalaki. One time, he had that barter, you know, she goes out of the house and negosyante, so she sells yung pinukpok daw. Pinukpok is cassava, I think, powdered or something, in order for her to earn something because she wants to go to school. They were in a farm. The farm was owned by my lola. And she was, they were so poor. So she hardly had clothes. So she said, I remember she said, I only had one or two pairs of something. Basta not more than two. Tapos, tinatahian siya ng kanyang, ang eldest is female. So, silang dalawa lang ang babae, lahat lalaki. So, most of the time, nabiyuda kasi yung lola ko. So, just like, sino yung nawala ng namatay ang mother? Well, okay, Nikki. My...
Miga Bilen, huh? Yung namatay ang mother early.
Sa kay mama, ang lolo ko naman matay when she was 3 months old na CBA ba. So lola had to care for 9 children. And wala, talagang negosyo, tapos kung ano-ano lang ang makita para mabuhay, pero sa bukid kasi. So they were able to, yung isang brother ng mama ko naging lawyer, something like that. May mga, si mama naging teacher kasi she really wanted to go to school on her own, na talagang on the industry siya. So with us, yeah, she was so strict but very, very religious, because every time we had to pray, you know, very strict. Hindi kami makalaro. Ako, hindi pwede dahil I care for my siblings. Tinitila ko na lang yung mama. No. You better take care of this and this and this. Alam, may assignment kami. Ako, every Friday, maglaba kami ng mama ko. Yung kapatid ko, yung sumunod sa akin, magplancha. Yung mga maliliit, hala, sila pinapakain ng pangatlo, maglugaw or whatever. So, ganun, may assignment. And she was very also negosyante kasi maestra siya, tapos yung papa ko government employee lang, tapos yun, they struggled hard. Pero papa ko, nagluluto, nag-ano sa part na niyan. At sa mama ko, dito sa amin na, very strict in cleaning. So ako, hala, naglalampaso. Every morning yan, every morning. Tapos, very strict nga kasi pagka nakita na natapos na bang ang paglilinis, gaganyanin yung corner.
Kung may dust.
Oo, gina-inspeksyon.
Yung blind.
So we grew up like that. Pero he was ambitious. She was ambitious. Ako kasi ang eldest, 9 din kami. What if never the cousin tayo, no? Lagi sa dalawa. Tapos sabi niya, halika. Tapos sabi ko, ma, ano pa ang maging ako? Kasi tinatanong sa aming teacher ko, same writing, and then you say, to be what? To be a doctor, to be a teacher, to be something else. Sabi niya, doctor. Sabi niya, ha? Sabi ko, ma, gusto mo mag-doktor ako? Sabi ko, hindi. Ilan. So she strived hard. She strove hard. Binutahan pala niya yung kung ano-ano mga makuha niya resources, by very resourceful. Pumunta sa Aquario Capital, Kusang Capital, Kanya, ay, pagkani mo ng exam si Luki. Tapos sabi niya, halika. Oh, pinakuha ko ng exam. Sabi ko, ma, wala ko. Hindi ko alam kung anong isasagot siya. Ay, naku, halika. Magdasal tayo. Sabi niya, magdasal lang tayo. Pumasa ako. Naku.
Because of the dasal of the mother.
Believe ako talaga sa faith niya, no? Tapos, no, after the, may scholarship na 4 years sa Aquana, yung salesman niya rin ang scholarship, eh, konti lang naman yon, high school lang. Pagka-college, ito na naman siya. Ah, halika, sabi niya. Nasa Veles na ako. Huwag ka nag-exam. Sabi ko, alam, ma, ito na naman. Wala, parang isasagot ko dyan, wala kong review. Sabi niya, ayaw, halika. Sabi ko, ma, hindi pwede. Meron akong exam sa ganito. Tapos sabi niya, puntahan natin ang registrar. Pinuntahan ang registrar. Sinama ko, ay, makasumama. Halika. Ano ang exam mo? Kailangan makakuha ka na exam na ito. Tapos sabi ko, sige, pumunta kami. Pinaunak na naman ako ng registrar sa Veles. Sabi niya, okay, mag-special exam ka lang. Sabihin ko sa teacher mo. Hala, pumasa kaya. Pero siya, that time, she was, buntis, pregnant sa last na child, yung, I mean, yung brother ko namatay dun, yung si Amit, Nick, I thank you so much.
Sino yung si Ramses at sino ngayon?
Ang laki na paa niya, nag-edema, edematos, ang hina niya, sabi ko, nahawa na ba ako, puntahan namin ang, yung sa city central noon, doon kumuha ng exam. Halika, sabi niya. Kuha ka ng examen. Tapos dito ako. I'll see the street. Tapos, titingnan mo ako pag mahirap ang question. Mahirap daw. Ano, titingnan mo ako. Dito lang ako, nakaupo. Buti naman ako, na-assign sa isang portion na ang pintuan, diretso ang mata ko pag makita siya sa tree. Ayun na. Sabi ko, ma, sabi niya, huwag ka na, believe. Sabi niya, pag mahirap ang exam, bago ka mag-take sa exam, sabihin mo, ama ko, sabi niya, i-offer mo lahat. Help me. Sabi niya, get into my mind and into my head. Ituro mo sa akin kung ano ang sulat ko, ang answer. Sabi ganun. Ala, di follow na the leader. Follow ako. Very strict na tao. Natakot talaga ko, ayokong malating ko. Sabi, okay. Pasok na ako doon. Huwag makita. Ito na naman. Ano na yung mathematics? Naku, hindi. Alam ito. Sabi ko, because of 2:10, may minutes na kailangan matapos mo. And so may minutes. Galing pag Philadelphia. Di, anong alam ko doon sa mga American ko, ano, mga sabi ko, eto na. Tapos tumingin ako sa kanya. Pray siya. Sabi niya, pray. Nakita ko siya mga na. Pray lang siya. Pray din ako. Sabi ko, oh Lord, turuan mo lang ako. Hindi ako marunong magkwenta nito. Tapos sabi, kung ano na papasok sa isip ko, yun na. Ay, sige. Sabi ko, Lord, I don't know. Ano ito? Number one. Papasok sa isip ko, B. Okay, B. Tapos sabi niya, tingnan mo lang yung kanya, yung ano mo, questions na, ay, ang answers mo. Pag makita mo na, hindi pwede yung computer na, dito A, puntang D, puntang C, puntang B, hindi pwede yun. Pero ganyan, yung hagdan daw. Tinignan ko naman, pag maghagdan, pag may tiwarik na ano, i-erase ko. Bahala na, wala akong question. Umasa! Umasa! Sabi niya, ako matutuloy itong kanyang ambisyon na pagka-doktor.
So ang faith ng mother mo, faith ng mother mo ang and her prayers. And her prayers.
Yung aking apparition ano experience sa Walk to Mary. Ito ngayon, punta na kami tapos this is the second time na pumunta kami. Third time pala kasi nung pangalawang time, dinala kami ni Mayet Fiel Correros nung nandito si Lisa, di pinunta namin yon. Wala talagang nangyari sa first and second ko na pagpunta sa Boston Mary sa Wisconsin. Yung pilgrimage, yung recent pilgrimage na wala ako, hindi ako nakapag-attend ba sa Prayer Warrior. Ito, pumasok ng kami si Inday, sabi ng mga yung leader namin, those who
pray, you get inside apparitions kasi yung mga iba, we will pray for those who are walking for Walk to Mary na mga grupo. So, nag-pray kami doon, pumasok kami si Inday, talagang wala, nakakita kami ng isang linya na mag-confession. So doon lang kami ako nagpray ako si Inday, sabi ko magpray ka. Alam mo, biglang napakabango. Biglang lumaganap ang bango. Sabi ko, Rose Petals ito? Rose. Tapos sininaw ko ano. Lahat ng continuous naman ang movement. Sabi ko, saan tayo taling yun? Pero napakabago for a while. Ay, naku, nakaiyak ako talaga. Inspire,
Mama Mary ang roses.
Mama Mary.
Oo. And her presence, alam mo ang presence niya is you can smell roses. Yun ang sabi. Oh.
Sabi ko, pero hindi ko ito sinabi sa grupo. I kept it. Isinare ko na sa June.
Oo.
She was there. She was
really Mama Mary.
I was praying so hard for our friends, for all of us, for the prayer warrior, everything. Na-pray na ako dun. Bigla siya. Tapos sabi ni Father Aitona, the director is Philam, or Filipino ba siya, indecent. Tapos,
Father Aitona? Who is
Father
your...
Father Aitona, alam mo?
I know him. Oh my God, you're so lucky. Why? You're so blessed. No, he's a very, very good preacher. Very good preacher. Father Joel Aitona.
Tapos sabi niya, whoever would want to join the confraternity, parang sabi ko, nagsulat na kami ni Inday, nakatagap na kami ng yung confirmation na member sa confraternity, no? Tapos sabi niya, pero hindi ko kasi sigurado, so pumunta kami. Tapos sabi niya, binibless niya yung mga religious articles na, no, pang masa ba. Tapos sabi niya, now you will be a member of this confraternity. This is membership all over the world. Millions will pray for you. But the requirement is, number one, at least in 1 week, you pray 3 times. Yung lahat ng iba-ibang ano rosary mysteries, no?
Which we do sa prayers natin.
Oo, sabi ko, kuha yan sa prayer warrior.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi morning, evening, ako ba nagjo-joy pag wala akong trabaho, morning, evening, o kung wala akong, kung may mga commitments. Basta, ahahabol ako. Tapos number two, you pray for yourself and for the intentions of others. Kuha pa rin natin yan sa prayer warrior. Because we pray for our own in our group and we pray for others who are humihingi. Diba? Ang daming mga nakakuha ng ano. Yeah. Tapos yung pangatlo, do service. Parang spread ang good news of salvation. Kuha pa rin natin yan because we do the ministry, we do the work. Sabi ko, sabi niya, i-encourage mo kung sino ang gusto mag-join para makakuha sila, ma-pray sila sa whole world. Kaya ang dami natin, the whole world, ang ministry na to.
We will talk about that, Tita Bex. Kasi ang mga requirements is yung ginagawa na natin.
Oo. Sabi ko, kuha sa prayer
and I know him. He is the one, he is the preacher in Fear Not.
Ah.
Yeah. Father Aitona, magkakapatid sila, puro pare. May another brother siya, I think twin brother niya yata or brother lang na pare din na preaching ang ano nila, ang ang ano nila is preaching, ang specialty. Very, very good.
Si Mama Mary talaga. There Mama was Mary. One who had the miracle. The first time na napunta kami, the change of from Our Lady of Good Help to Our Lady of Champion na ngayon. Nakakita siya ng image ni Mama Mary on the right side sa may dipeta while the priest was ministering the mass. Very milagroso si Mama Mary. Very miraculous.
So that's what, yeah, so that's what we have learned, no, and taught by our mother, no. It's not aside from telling us, no, but through example, by their example, naka-in love tayo kay Mama Mary, mm-hmm. no. Just like all of us here, that our mothers taught us to be strong, to be values, no? Values talaga, moral values, spiritual values natin, mga choices in life natin, hardworking, loving, compassion, everything taught by our mother. That's why ito na tayo ngayon. And we continue to pray for our mothers wherever they are. Kay Tita Helen, especially na nandyan pa si Nanay, 92 years old na, and to our own mothers in heaven, because we owe them a lot, really. Because of them, because of their hard work, ito na tayo ngayon. Ito na tayo. So, amen and praise the Lord. And we entrust to Mama Mary as we were taught by our mother to love Mama Mary as Jesus loved his own mother. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Beautiful day and beautiful reflections about our mother. And thank you for the sharing. Thank you for the reflections. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Miga Belen for the closing prayer.
Yes. Lord, please grant us patience as we wait on you to fulfill the promises in your word. Help us to be full of grace and compassion when dealing with others. Help us to love others as you have loved us. Lord, thank you for your never-ending patience with us. Help us to be patient people so that we may point others towards you. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And all together, please, glory be to the Father,
to the Son, to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, now and ever, without end.
Amen.
In the name of the Father,
and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Happy Mother's Day. Thank you very much. Thank you for the sharing. Beautiful sharing, beautiful reflection. Love you guys.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.